the outer space. Do you ever wonder if there are aliens out there?
Not really, but did you know that immigrants are referred to as aliens in the United States?
Really? Maybe we should have a dialogue about the rhetoric used against immigrants.
There's 104 days of summer vacation, and school comes along just to end it. So the annual problem for our generation is finding a good way to spend it.
Like maybe
building a rocket or fighting a mummy or climbing up the Eiffel Tower. Discovering something that doesn't exist,
hey,
or giving a monkey a shower. Surfing tidal waves, creating nanobots, or locating Frankenstein's brain.
It's over here!
Finding a dodo bird, painting a continent, or driving our sister insane.
Phineas!
As you can see, there's a whole lot of stuff to do before school starts this fall.
Come on, Barry!
So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all. So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all.
Mom! Phineas and Ferb are making a title sequence!
Here are the questions. What do you think of when you hear the word alien?
Number two, what nationality or identity comes to mind when you hear this term and why?
Three, should immigrants be referred to as aliens? Why or why not?
Four, moving forward, do you have different thoughts about your own rhetoric or that of others regarding immigrants?
Additionally, we have seven ground rules that we're presenting to the people in our dialogue. First, do not laugh or smirk at other people. Second, speak concisely but allow others time to speak as well. Third, no rude or foul language and no name calling. Fourth, be mindful of nonverbal communication, no eye rolling or rude gestures. Fifth, come with an open mind. Even if you don't agree, still listen to others' arguments. Sixth, try to understand every position. And seventh, actively listen and participate in the dialogue.
Wow. That was more interesting than I thought it would be.
Yeah, what happened in yours?
Well, I conducted my dialogue with a bunch of people in my residence hall, and basically what went down was that two of them actually believed that the word alien was harmful, while the other two didn't believe so, especially in technical matters. In this sense, we actually saw that one of the persons was an immigrant, and he actually believed that the word alien was okay, so there was definitely an interesting dichotomy there. But overall, nothing really escalated because we had those ground rules in the very beginning, and we learned a lot from each other. What about you, Ferb?
Well, in my dialogue, it actually got pretty heated. I did it with my roommate, my sister's roommate, and my sister. And let's just say we were all over the political spectrum. So my really conservative roommate and my really liberal roommate ended up getting pretty hostile towards each other. One of them even ended up saying, "How would you like it if someone called you an alien?" And in that case, I had to remind them of the ground rules. And while I don't think anyone's mind was really changed in this dialogue, it was clear to see that we all learned a lot. What about you, Isabella?
Well, I had my dialogue with three of my other close friends. And while it wasn't pretty heated, my friends did ignore the ground rule about laughing. They laughed quite a bit in our dialogue about things that weren't entirely relevant to the questions. However, they did talk about how the word alien was not bad in the sense being alone, but they said it was bad when paired with the term illegal.
Wow, awesome. What about you, Perry? Okay then. So, how did y'all feel about dialogues as a technique for addressing controversial topics?
Dialogues are a great way to get to hear other people's opinions in a safe space where you know that you aren't going to be judged and you can learn from others' perspectives. Isabella, what thoughts do you have about the process and how it would work in real life?
In real life, it's definitely different because of the tendency for people to defend their positions. We had several fights break out despite the ground rules. However, it was super fun. I enjoyed working with y'all as a team.
Even though it was really hard to schedule, I'm really glad that we had these dialogues so that we could learn more about other people.
Oh no, it's Candace. We can't let her find out about our dialogues.